Okay, so we'll start now the next unit, that is slope and deflection. So this chapter is very, very important, and not much concepts are there. It is a formula based chapter, so if you remember all the formulas, then this is a very, very easy chapter and a very scoring chapter. So now let's start with what is slope and what is deflection. So first we'll draw a simply supported beam here. So a beam which is having a hinge support and a roller support. So this is the simply supported beam. Now on this simply supported beam, there is a loading which is acting. And which type of load is this? This is a point load. So the point load is acting in the downward direction. So due to this, what will happen? The original beam will now bend. Okay. So due to this vertically downward loading, this original beam has now bent in this shape. So this shape is called as elastic curve. Sometimes it is also called as deflection curve. Now, let's take an example of a cantilever beam. So, in case of cantilever beam, if the load is acting in vertically downward direction, so after bending, the beam will look like this. It will bend in this way, downward bending. What is this called as? This shape. This shape is called as same elastic curve or deflection curve. This we already studied. Now what is slope and what is deflection? So let's take a point A here on the beam. Okay, so this point A is on the original beam, that is the beam before the loading, before the P load is acting on the beam. This is the point A. Now after loading, what has happened? The beam has bent in this direction or in this way. So this A point will be shifted here. Now the new location of A point is this. So we'll name this point as A dash. Now this distance, okay, the distance between the original position of a point and the position of the same point after loading, this is called as deflection. Okay. As this deflection is at point A, hence we'll name it as deflection at A. So deflection we will denote by a sign which is delta. Okay. Now, similarly, if we take here point A, this is the original position of point A before loading. After loading, the same point is present here because the beam has bent in such a way. So this is A dash. This distance now, this is called as deflection of point A or deflection at point A. If you look properly, what is the deflection at this point? If I name this point as B, what is the deflection at point B? It is zero. Deflection at point B is zero because the original position of point B before loading and the final position of point B after loading is same. Similarly, if this is point C, then what is deflection at point C? This is also zero. One more point to observe here is the shape of the elastic curve in simply supported beam and the shape of elastic curve in cantilever beam. So this is our simply supported beam and this is cantilever beam. So if you look carefully, then this shape looks like this. This elastic curve shape is this. This shape is nothing but this is a sagging shape. Okay. Whereas in case of cantilever beam, when the loading is acting, the beam bends in which shape? It bends in hogging shape. So with this now, we have understood what is deflection and what are the shape of beam after loading in case of simply supported beam and cantilever beam. Now the last point to see is what is slope. Slope is denoted by theta. Okay. Slope is measured in radians. Don't get confused here. Theta is measured generally in degrees everywhere. But here in slope and deflection chapter, you have to remember that the slope we will be calculating, this will be in radians. Now what is the slope? So to find out the slope at any point, we have to draw a tangent at that point. Okay. To find out the slope at any point, we have to draw a tangent at that point. So if we take the point A dash here, so the slope, or we can say the tangent at that point A dash is this one. So this is a tangent here. Now whatever is the slope of this tangent, whatever is the slope of this tangent, this will give the value of slope. So in this case, now this tangent is present at A, so it will give us the value of theta A. Now if I want to find out what is the value of theta B, then what I will do, I will draw a tangent at this point. So the tangent will look like this. Now whatever is the slope of this line or slope of this tangent, this will give us the value of theta B because it is at point B. Similarly, in this case, it will be theta C. So to find out the slope, what we have to do? We have to draw a tangent at that point and then calculate the slope of tangent. And that slope of tangent will give us the slope at that point. And slope is measured in radians. Now, in next video, we'll write down the definition of slope and deflection, and then we will see how to convert degrees also into radians. The conversion of degrees into radians.